Pep Guardiola has coached some of the most tactically astute and iconic players of all time. The list of players that he's coached ranges from Sergio Busquets to Kevin De Bruyne to Thiago Alcantara. However, there is only one player that he's ever labeled as the most intelligent player that he's ever coached. That man is Philipp Lahm. The German is well known for being one of the most versatile and selfless players to ever grace the field. His ability to read the game was nothing short of enchanting. As a matter of fact, he was even given the nickname, the Magic Dwarf. As he's now been retired for a couple of years, we can now take a closer look into what made him so special. With that being said, how good was Philipp Lahm really? What's going on, everyone? Hope you're all doing well. In this video, we're going to be taking a brief look into the iconic career of the great Philipp Lahm. Born in Munich, Germany, both of Philipp Lahm's parents were massive football enthusiasts. In fact, his mother was a youth leader at their local football team, FT Gern, while his father was a player for the same team. Therefore, it only makes sense that he grew up to be football crazy himself. In an interview, his mother once recalled, "He was always with the ball, in the house and in the yard." Knowing this, it comes as no surprise that he was scouted by Bayern Munich at the age of 11. Lahm's talent and potential to become something great was not lost on his youth coaches at Bayern either. One of his coaches, Hermann Hummels, once even said, "If Philipp Lahm does not make it in the Bundesliga, nobody will." And Lahm definitely lived up to the hype. In his youth career at Bayern, he won the Bundesliga youth title twice. The second time he won it, he was the captain. In hindsight, this was clear foreshadowing for what was to come in his professional career. Fast forward to 2003. Lahm was 19 by the time he was introduced to the Bayern Munich first team. It's important to note that up until this point, he had only really played as either a right back, a right midfielder, or a defensive midfielder for his entire life. However, due to the fact that Bayern had the legendary fullback pairing of Bixent Lizarazu and Willy Sanyol in their prime at the time, there was essentially no room for Lahm to break into the first team. As a result of this, Lahm transferred to VfL Stuttgart for the 2003-2004 and the 2004-2005 Bundesliga seasons. Although he was predominantly a right-sided player until then, Lahm was converted into a left-back by the Stuttgart coach at the time. Despite this not being his natural position, he showed his versatility by making the position his own. And thanks to the performances at Stuttgart, he was even called up to the national team and was selected as a starter for the UEFA Euro 2004. Now, German fans may have selectively chosen to forget this tournament as die Mannschaft tumbled out at the group stages. However, Lahm was widely praised as being one of the sole positive aspects for Germany in this entire competition. So much so that these performances, in combination with his first full season of professional football, earned him a second place finish in the German Footballer of the Year Awards for the year of 2004. It was at this point that the world truly began to take notice of Philipp Lahm. Fast forward to the end of Lahm's loan spell with Stuttgart in 2005, and unfortunately, he still found himself unable to break into the Bayern starting lineup, although the reasoning this time was that he had suffered a torn cruciate ligament injury while still on loan. Knowing what we know now, and looking back, it's hard to imagine that the Lahm that we're all familiar with ever struggled to get into the Bayern first team. It just goes to show you that even the greatest have to work their way to the top. After being sidelined for months, Lahm finally got his chance to play in the Bayern first team in early 2006, and grabbed it with both hands. Willy Sanyol was still the starting right back, so Lahm was forced to remain in the left back position that he'd adopted while on loan. Although, due to the performances that he was putting in, no one would blame you for believing that he had played there his entire life. At the back, he was an absolute rock. He had the tendency of cutting inside to provide inch-perfect passes and even score the odd goal or two. Lahm's time had truly come. Over the next few years, Lahm continued to improve and won his first two Bundesliga titles in 2006 and 2008. However, even the great Philipp Lahm had his share of controversy during his playing career. After speaking in an interview in November 2009, Lahm publicly criticized the Bayern Munich board for having an unclear tactical philosophy and an erratic transfer strategy. Now, there were a few reasons why this was such a big deal at the time. Firstly, Bayern had just lost the 2008-2009 Bundesliga title to Wolfsburg. And secondly, there were several rumors linking Lahm to clubs such as Barcelona and Manchester United. To add on to this, the club hadn't even authorized this interview in the first place. This led Bayern to handing Lahm with the biggest fine that they've ever given to a player in their entire history, a sum of roughly €25,000. The aftermath of this interview left Bayern Munich fans divided. Half of them were angry that Lahm would speak out against the club like that. The other half were praising him for his honesty during a time when Bayern clearly were not at their strongest. Despite this entire debacle, Lahm received close to zero backlash on the field. His starting position was left untouched, and he was even given the captaincy of the German national team in the months that followed, making him the youngest German captain in the entire history of the national team. If anything, his performances only became better and more consistent, although this may be partly due to the fact that Lahm finally took on his favourite right-back position in the very same season. In the months that followed all of this controversy, Bayern went right back to winning ways by claiming the top spot in the 2009-2010 season. As a side note, this season marked the beginning of what would eventually turn into one of the strongest wide partnerships in all of Europe. With Philipp Lahm at right-back and Arjen Robben at right-wing, the two caused absolute havoc to the opposition. Their understanding of each other's passing, positional sense, and movement was out of this world. It's safe to say that you can all expect an Arjen Robben video in the near future. Moving forward to the 2012-2013 Bundesliga season, Lahm had recently been made the permanent captain of Bayern Munich, following the retirement of Marc van Bommel. And despite the fact that Bayern had lost out on the Bundesliga title to Borussia Dortmund for 2 years straight, Lahm was about to have the most successful two-year period of his entire career. To kick things off, Bayern Munich won a famous treble in 2013. This consisted of the Bundesliga title, the DFB Pokal, and the Champions League. To this day, no other German team has done this, except for Bayern Munich, 7 years later in 2020. But the crazy successes didn't end here for Lahm. As we all know, he went on to captain Germany to their fourth World Cup victory in 2014. Something that many may have overlooked is that although Germany had been crowned as world champions 3 times prior to this tournament, this was their first World Cup win since East and West Germany were reunified in 1990. Because of this, many people believed that this was the most significant of all their victories to date. Along with being a world-class footballer, being the man that lifted this trophy as German captain made Philipp Lahm a certified legend. In the years that followed the 2014 World Cup, Lahm began to enter the back end of his career. Despite slowing down, Lahm would continue to start for Bayern Munich as their captain and put in some very solid and consistent performances in the process. In addition to that, he picked up 3 more Bundesliga titles before eventually retiring from football altogether on the 20th of May 2017. All in all, Lahm won 22 trophies in his career, including 8 Bundesliga titles, 1 Champions League title, and a World Cup. Crazy numbers. To quote Philipp Lahm himself, "Whether we have the best individual players doesn't matter. You have to have the best team." In the last few decades, there have been very few players that have been more qualified to utter these words than the great man himself. Philipp Lahm was the definition of a team player. His selfless playstyle and versatility made him into one of the most iconic players to ever grace the game. And there we have it. How do you guys feel about Philipp Lahm as a player? And even further to that, how much do you think Lahm would go for in today's transfer market? If you liked the video, feel free to leave a like, but no pressure, of course. Cheers, and I'll catch you in the next one.